Good morning, dear students. I hope you have completed the homework as I have given you, and I have given the one magic square and the two sums that you have to solve. Okay. So today we are going to start question number 9. So the question number 9 is use this sign. Exercise. 1.1 Question number 9. Use sign greater than or equal. Here we have to check the LHS sign as well as RHS sign. The same thing we have done in question number 8. Okay? So let's start the solve. I'm solving the first one. Then minus 8 plus minus 4 blank minus 8 minus minus 4. Now in these two integers, which sign will come? That will first solve it and then we will decide which sign will come into this box. Okay? So let's first we solve that in this sign plus minus minus. So minus 8 minus 4. Now as we have studied the property of integers, 8 plus 4 minus minus plus. So 8 plus 4 that is 12. And here we have to follow the bigger number sign. The minus, 8 has the minus negative sign. So we have to put here 12. Now let's redo minus 8. Minus minus plus plus 4. Minus plus minus. 8 minus 4 that is 4. But here the number sign is the negative. Why? Because 8 number is bigger than the 4. So here minus 4 is the greater. Now in this 2, our both answers is in the negative. Okay, both has the negative integer. Now from this, which number is bigger? Minus 4. In integers, in the first, while we had studied the type of integers, at that time only I had explained you in an integer, what totally opposite of that, when we are putting the less than or greater than sign. Integer mein jo smaller number hai, wo number line mein sabse pehle aata hai. Okay? For example, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Minus 4 will come first. That number is the bigger than the minus 12. So the answer should be less than. Clear? So this way you have to solve the whole question. That is question number 9. In which I am solving the only 3 questions and you have to solve 2 questions from your book. That is question number, D1 that you have to take. Okay, so we'll start with the B and C. That both you have to do in the homework. We'll study the D1. Okay, so let's be solve D1. This is the question. First, we'll simplify the signs. Plus minus. 39 plus minus, minus 24 and minus. Here as you can see, the 15 doesn't have a sign, though this is put it into the bracket. But if there is no sign, so the number should be a positive number. So plus minus, minus 15. Okay? So when 39 minus 24, you will get 50 and minus 50. Your answer should be 0. Okay? So let's resolve from this side. Plus minus minus and minus minus plus 36 plus minus minus 52 minus minus plus 36. Now here the plus 36 and 36 minus 52. So you will get answer in a minus. Okay. So how much number you will get? You will get minus 60. And because 52 minus 36 and plus 36. Now minus plus minus 36 minus 60. You will get 20. But 20 is the positive because the 36 has the positive sign. So in which from these two numbers, which number is bigger? Obviously 20. So the sign is the less than. Clear? Now let's we solve E. This is a question of E. Now first let's we do simple thing is here the addition between the two numbers, simply addition. So just in the both sides. Okay. This is it from both sides. So let me do add first. Minus 231 plus 79 plus 51. You will get 130. Now let's we do subtraction because plus minus minus. So whatever answer we'll get in the negative number because 231 is the bigger. So 231 minus 130, you will get 101. Okay. Now here same, we'll do the same. Just do the simple addition. Minus 399 plus 159 plus 81. So you will get 240. Now whatever answer we will get, it will be in a minus. So let's do the subtraction. We will get 159. Okay. So now from this 101 and then 159, which number is bigger? What you have to do is you should keep it in mind which number is came first in the number line from the 0 onwards. Which number will come first? 101. So this number is bigger. So your answer is greater than. Okay. So we have finished the exercise. That is, we have completed the question number 9. And next question is question number 10. Let's we move on. Let's we solve question number 10. Question number 10 is very interesting, you can say, because it is related with the monkey and the water tank. He jumps upwards and downwards. Okay? So from that jump, we have to find on which stage, in which step the monkey reach. Monkey will reach. Okay? So let me see the question is, a water tank has a step inside it. A water tank hai, uske andar steps hai. Assume this, maine jo yahan pe figure draw ki hai, keep it in mind that this is the water tank. Suppose this is the water tank aur uske andar steps hai. Okay? Now, a monkey is sitting on the topmost step, that is the first step, and the water level is the last step, that is the ninth one. Okay? Jo monkey hai wo yahan pe baitha hai. Okay? Jo monkey hai wo first step pe hai. So you get it, the main concept is there is a water tank, there is inside the water tank there are the steps. On the first step there is a monkey and on the last step there is a water tank. Means this is the ninth step. Okay? So our first question is, he jumps 3 steps down. Jo monkey hai, 3 jump, 1 jump mein 3 जंप ऊपर लगाता है, ओके। जब वो एक जंप में तीन स्टेप्स कवर कर लेता है और फिर ऊपर जाने के लिए एक जंप में दो स्टेप कवर कर लेता है, ओके। सो इन हाउ मेनी जंप्स विल ही रीच द वाटर लेवल, कि कितने जंप में वो यहाँ लास्ट एट द लास्ट स्टेप ही विल रीच इन हाउ मेनी जंप। सो लेट्स बी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट स्टेप। Here we'll write that he will reach the first step, first jump, और यहाँ पे आएगा step, okay? Similarly यहाँ पे second, third, four, three, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11. Okay? Means if we don't know how many jumps we need to reach the water level, means उसको ninth step तक पहुँचना है. Clear? So you will what you will do in the first jump. Three steps go downwards. So, मम्मी यहाँ पे है, तो तीन step नीचे जाएगा. One, two, three. तो we will reach fourth step. Okay? So, here 3 + 1. तो you will get fourth number step. Okay? हमने यहाँ पे 3 क्यों लिखा? क्योंकि वो तीन step नीचे जा रहा है. और वो कौन से step है? First step से तीन step नीचे जा रहा है. Here, so that here we have written 1. Okay? Now, on the fourth step, the two steps will go back. Fifth, fourth step, two steps are possible. 1 and 2. So he will reach 2. In the second step, 4 - 2. So he will not go back. Second step. Wapas. Second step is 3 jump niche. 1, 2, 3. You will reach at the fifth step. So 2 + 3. So you reach at fifth step. Now up fifth step se upar do jump. 1 and 2. Clear? So 5 - 2. So again wapas upar se step pe pahunch gaya. थर्ड स्टेप. अब थर्ड स्टेप से वो वापस तीन स्टेप नीचे आएगा. 1, 2, 3. तो वापस वो सिक्स स्टेप पे पहुंच गया. 6 - 3 + 3. सो वो रीच है 3. सॉरी यहाँ पे 3 आएगा. 3 के ऊपर नीचे आएगा तो 6 स्टेप. ओके. नाउ अब वो सिक्स स्टेप पे 2 जंप है तो फोर्थ स्टेप है. तो सिक्स स्टेप से दो स्टेप ऊपर गया तो टू. इसीलिए हमने यहाँ माइनस किया. अगर वो नीचे जाता है तो प्लस, अगर ऊपर जाता है तो माइनस. तो सिक्स माइनस टू यू विल गेट दी फोर. अब वो फोर स्टेप पे वापस आ गया. अब वो तीन स्टेप वापस नीचे जाएगा तो 4 + 3 वो नीचे जा रहा है इसलिए +3. तो वो कौन से स्टेप पे पहुंच गया? 7 स्टेप पे. अब वो 7 स्टेप पे है तो दो स्टेप वापस ऊपर जाएगा -2. तो वो कौन से स्टेप पे पहुंचा? फिफ्थ नंबर के स्टेप पे. अब वो फिफ्थ नंबर के स्टेप पे है तो वापस तीन स्टेप नीचे आएगा यानी कि 8. तो +3 वो विल गेट 8. ओके. नाउ अब वो 8 नंबर के स्टेप पे है तो वापस वो टू स्टेप ऊपर जाएगा तो विल गेट दी -2. तो हमें वो सिक्स नंबर के स्टेप पे मिलेगा. अब वो सिक्स नंबर के स्टेप पे तीन नंबर आए. 1, 2, 3. तीन स्टेप नीचे तो वो पहुंच गया डायरेक्ट ग्राउंड वाटर लेवल. तो 6 + 3 दैट इज 9 स्टेप. तो वो 9 जंप लगाने के लिए, सॉरी 9 स्टेप पे पहुंचने के लिए उसको कितनी जंप लगानी पड़ी? टोटल 11 जंप. ओके. सो आवर आंसर we will reach water level by 11 jumps. Okay, here we have to keep the most important thing that we should keep it in mind, that when the monkey goes downside, three step downside, we consider as the plus, and here you can see plus. Okay, here the one plus three. Okay, three steps. And when jump upper aata hai, then minus two. So here you can see minus two plus three. Two wapas upper aaya. माइनस टू तो वापस पीछे गया, इसी तरह आपको सभी में देखने को मिलेगा. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. अभी वो दो सॉल्व करने बाकी है. फर्स्ट दैट मच यू नीड टू बी क्लियर. दैट इज ऑल क्वेश्चन नंबर टू. दैट इज आफ्टर ड्रिंकिंग वाटर ही वांट्स टू गो बैक. वो नाइन्थ लेवल पे आ गया था, तो ही वॉन्ट्स टू go back. For this, he jumps four steps up, and then jumps two steps down. So four step will be considered as the minus, and two step will be plus. In our first question only we had shown that when monkey jumps downwards, will add. Okay, but monkey jump backward will subtract it. So here this is the same. जब वो monkey चार step ऊपर जाता है, तब हम minus करेंगे. अब two step नीचे आएगा, तब हम plus करेंगे. So in how many jumps will he reach back the top step? He will jump. Okay, he will jump to reach top step. Is first jump, similarly second, third and fourth, fifth, etc. Clear? Now, let's see, the monkey is here on the water level. वो चार step ऊपर जा रहा है. 1, 2, 3, 4. Clear? एक jump में वो 9th number के step से वो 5th number के step पे आया. कितने steps उसने run किए? 4. 9 minus 4 is equal to 5th number step. समझ में आया? Minus 4 क्यों किया? क्योंकि वो 4 step ऊपर जा रहा है. Reach top step. So this is about question number 2. Now the one question is left, we'll solve it. First you will write down in your notebook. For this graph, you will have to use the pencil only. Don't use the pen. The third question is about if the number of steps moved down is represented by a negative integer, as we have done, moved down is represented by the negative integers, and the number of steps moved up by a positive integer. Okay? Represent this move in this part, A and B, 1 and 2, by completing the following. Means ki first ye separate question diya hai ki agar negative integers jo hai wo represent kiya jata hai when the monkey moves up, okay, and the positive integer represent negative integer represent when the monkey moves down. So complete this move by the following. Keep minus 3 plus 2 continue minus 8 because monkey jo hai properties of integers. Till that, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you all.